Hey guys, welcome back. Today I thought I'd do a video on shelf etiquette, just generally looking at the best ways to kind of help preserve your books over time, how to best kind of lay them out, put them on off the shelf in an appropriate manner, just to kind of not damage your books in the kind of long term. So grab yourself a drink, guys, get comfy, and let's do this. As much as possible, you want to try and store the similar sized books together. This allows them to support each other on the shelf, but I just also find that it just looks nicer. So I've set up a little bit of a random shelf here where we've got some humanoids, oversized books, the standard sized books, larger trades, a mix of normal trades, and then kind of a manga size. And you can see how this all kind of supports itself across on the shelf, and how these are all kind of supported across on each other as well. Now, the one thing I would say is, typically speaking, with soft covers more than hard covers, you find that the backs of the books kind of flap about a little bit because they're not as thick as the front. So sometimes you do actually want to put a hard cover kind of in between some of the soft cover sets, or just make sure that your entire shelf sort of start to finish is the same size of soft cover, and then they're supporting each other kind of all the way through. Moving on from that to the best ways to support your books, you ideally want the size of any support to be the same size as the book that it's supporting. So if you do have a book end or something like that, ideally you want it to be as big as the book it's kind of going against. So if your shelves are sitting like this and you've got a couple of books kind of leaning over, you can take something like this and just slot it in the side. And because that's as big or bigger than the book that it's sitting up against, it now has all of our books sitting up straight and supported as if basically the shelf was just that little bit smaller. That stops your books leaning over. If you take one thing from this video, it's that your books shouldn't be randomly leaning over. That can damage the spine when it comes to hardcovers, but it can also just generally wear the edges of your book and stop them sitting upright generally. So it's something to avoid, and this is a really simple way just to fill out that space. You can also take other books, so even if a book doesn't fit in a series or something, you can slot them in. So I've been known to take the sort of Eagle Moss books I've got recently and just slot them in on shelves to fill in the gaps, and that can help, you know, support the shelf itself overall. If the thing you're using to create the larger kind of support isn't heavy or can't kind of hold up and you're not going to the end of the shelf, you can use something, just a heavy block. So this is just a random old cassette eraser, and just plopping that weight there at the end allows for the whole edge of this to support the book, but the weight stops the whole kind of lot falling over, and that just works like a typical kind of bookend. I'm not a fan of standard kind of the metal bookends that kind of go under your books, because I find that that can cause just as much wear or damage to the bottom of the books as they would leaning over in the first place. So I tend to avoid those, but any of the kind of just heavier bookends should be totally fine. But I personally think that you should put something there that's the size of the book, and that just helps support the books themselves overall. And I've not had any damage to, you know, any of the books that I've kind of had over time through using this method. There's not been any kind of ink seeping or issues like that from any of the boxes or things I've used. And I've used lots of different packaging, you know, things like, say, you know, Power Rangers box or anything like that, just to support things on my shelf, and that stops damage to the hardcovers, I say primary as the most expensive things, but just any of my books overall. So when you get larger omnibus, especially the Marvel ones that typically have a bit of a looser binding on them, the main block of the book can kind of hang down and basically sit against the bottom of the shelf. And that's straining the top end of the binding the entire time it's kind of sitting on that shelf. So it's not something you have to do, because typically these books are still fine just kind of sitting on the shelf as they are. But what I do is basically just take a sort of three layer of, this is just comic backing board that you use for your sort of normal bag and boarding. And I put that under the sort of page block. And when I'm putting that on the shelf, it just supports the block itself. helps keep the block of the book level. And on bigger books, as I say, like Omnibus, I just think that'll help preserve them a little bit more over time. Ideally, you want your shelf to be wider than the widest book that's going to be on that shelf. And you want to have your books slightly forward or towards the front of the shelf. This allows room if you need to push the books back at any point, and it also stops the books bashing up against the back of the shelf, which is only going to cause further kind of wear overall. Most of the key things I'm going to be talking about here is about protecting the main hardcover spine of the book itself. Ideally, we don't want to be touching this other than to potentially push the book onto the shelf. If you're taking the book off, we don't want to be pulling it anywhere here along the edge of the spine itself, because that can cause wear or separation. We don't want to be compressing the spine in any way to cause damage, and we don't want to be pulling at the top section here, which will damage the binding and potentially pull the hardcover to start sort of separating from the book. So ideally, with these books, we want to keep them in as best kind of condition as possible. So the next couple of points are going to be about how to do that in an appropriate manner. Point one, how to put a book on a shelf in a manner not to damage the sort of book. So you want to hold the book itself basically sort of either side of the hard block, not at the spine. And then if you don't have a ton of space to move the books into the shelf, what you want to do is pull the books that are currently there out. Now again, we don't want to be pulling by anything that's going to damage the books. So if we've got space here, we can just grab the hardcover of the book and slide out a little bit. And then the same with the other one. This gives us a bit more space to place this book in. And then if we put it in as far as it can before placing it down, and then we can basically push all three books in by their very edge, and we get a nice, clean fit. This doesn't cause any damage to the books putting it on the shelf. It's not slamming it down, it's not cramming it in, and there shouldn't be any kind of squeezing on the binding itself. Spacing-wise on the shelf, you always want to leave about enough space for an empty envelope or folded sheet of paper to be able to slide between the books. So you should be able to quite easily place that between any of the books on your shelf without any struggle. And then you know that those books are spaced but yet supported enough within the shelf itself. Contrary to what you may think, if you have a larger book like the Private Eye, which is a little bit kind of longer, and you want to place the book in on its side, you would expect that you wouldn't want to place it on the kind of curved edge or any of the nice kind of spine itself, because that might kind of scratch it or shelf wear on the shelf. But actually, that's the best place to put the book on, because if you put the book down on this edge, you're actually letting the weight of the block hang on the spine the entire time it's sitting on the shelf, and that'll wear the book over time. So if you're putting the book in on its side, you want to put it in with the spine down and then just slide that in again as much as possible, not touching the shelf, and then just place it down and slide in the last little bit. Now, this might seem like the simplest thing and that you shouldn't really need to explain it, but this is two nice ways to take your hardcovers off the shelf without, again, damaging any of the spine or binding of the book. So if you have plenty of clearance on the shelf, so there's plenty of space between the top of the hardcover and the shelf itself, then you should be able to reach over the books. Now, if you can do that, there's two ways that you can take the book out the shelf. You can either, firstly, put your hand to the back and at the very back of the block itself, push the block towards the spine to pull the book out a little and then lift it up. So if we do that, we can pull that out and then grab either side of the hard block to slide the book out of the shelf. Or if you can't reach all the way to the back because the book is a little bit taller, then what you can do is just place your finger on the, again, hard block of the paper, not the spine and not on the far edge here of the book, and just rock it back enough until you can grip either side of the hard cover, again, not at the very edge of the spine, but in on the hard block of the book itself. So again, if we do that here, we put our finger in, rock this back, grab either side of the block itself, and then lift the book out. If you can't get to the top because the books themselves are far too tall, you can push the other two just slightly back. And again, because you've got the spacing and these books are not too tight to each other, they're not going to push each other back and forward. And then we can grab the book itself again by either side of the hardcover and slide the book out and remove that from the shelf. And then I would just take this again by the block. So get your finger in a bit and pull this forward. And then again here. And then I can slide this back in. One last thing I'd want to note, guys, is that if you are storing books off of a shelf, especially if they are nicer hardcovers, stack them from the largest trim size at the bottom to the smallest trim size at the top, so essentially kind of like a pyramid, and they should be on some sort of hard surface. You don't want them sitting on anything soft or anything, and then that way they can properly be supported until you can get them onto a decent kind of shelf. Same things if you're going to be boxing them up and taking them anywhere. You shouldn't really stack your books like they would on a shelf when you're boxing them up. You should always box them down flat with, as the largest trim first. Alright guys, I hope I've not bored you too much with this video, but I hope that you've learnt a bit about how to preserve your collections and look after them in the long term, and about some of the things that I do to look after mine. As always, let me know below if there's anything different that you guys do, and anything that you know you've learnt from this that you maybe start doing yourselves going forward. As always though guys, thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing, and I'll see you guys next time.